Hey guys, Dagan here from PMTV UK with a beautiful sparkly number. This is the, I'm gonna say Gibson again, the very good Epiphone SG Special P-90s from the Inspired by Gibson range. And you guys out there on YouTube land are probably thinking, this guitar-y salesman on the computer is deliberately getting Gibson and Epiphone confused. What a silly bugger. No, these are really, really close. The new Inspired by range by Epiphone take the golden guitars from Gibson's lineup and faithfully recreate them for a little bit less money. It's not all just a new shaped headstock. This new Kalamazoo headstock does make something special when you look down and you kind of don't feel like you're playing an Epiphone, because these feel the most Gibson-y Epiphones I've ever played. They've really, really upped their game. SGs, they've got the 61, the standard, this P90 number, they've got 50s Les Pauls, 60s Les Pauls, classics, Firebirds, Flying Vs, Thunderbirds, all the semi-hollow body things. They're remarkable. They really knocked the ball out of the park with the Inspired by Gibson range. And this is this one, the SG Special. Wraparound bridge with a lightning bolt, mahogany, I should say. Comes in sparkly burgundy, which is this fantastic looking guitar, even though it's covered in my manky jawly fingerprints. Mahogany neck, classic style, little ivory button tuners. 22 medium jumbo frets with a Graphtech nut. P90 pickups, 50s classic twang, really bitey, really sharp pickups, but very, very dynamic. P90s react to your picking a lot more than a humbucker does, in my humble opinion. So when you dig in, they really bite, and when you back off a little bit, they kind of step back from the gate a little bit. CTS pots in all the Inspired by Gibson guitars, whether it be the SG or the Les Paul. And I love these kind of special junior kind of guitars, because they kind of work, like I said, the harder you hit them, the better the sound. I should say neck profile is a 60s SlimTaper neck, as it is on all of the SG Inspired by Gibson guitars. Dot inlays, as it was on the specials, with a little batwing pickguard and the squared off bit here. I think that's all the specs you want to know. You go to the PMT website if you want any more specs. But that's some history and some specs, and this is an A chord. So they really have that extra bit of honk as opposed to humbuckers, don't they? Trying to get around playing all the losing my voice. That was awful. Can I do that again? Trying to get around not playing any SG player riffs for copyright reasons. So, if you want to hear one of the variants of all the little tiny riffs I've played, you need to come into a store and try one of these out for yourselves. Guarantee you'll not be disappointed. I've been a Gibson player for a number of years now, and I've always adored Epiphones, and these have really, really changed the game. I can't wait to see what they're going to come out with these guitars. So this comes in Sparkling Burgundy and like a faded Pelham Blue Burst. SG's out the wazoo, Les Pauls, Firebirds, all the rest of the stuff. All the Inspired by Gibson range. And I think that's all the specs and sounds I've got out of this. So you need to come into a PMT store, try one out for yourselves. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to PMTV UK on YouTube for lots more cool guitar and music related content. If you want any more information on these lovely headstock buggers, go to pmtonline.co.uk or call into, like I said, one of our lovely shops. We are PMT House of Rock on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter. Give us a follow and a like to see pictures of these guitars with filters on. I've been Dagan, and I want all of these now. I'll see you later.